everyone. My name is Kia, and today is April the 4th. It's so great that you're able to join me for today's verse of the day. There's no better way than to start the day than in God's Word. My hope is to better equip each viewer to live authentically for God by expounding and applying Scripture to our lives. If you haven't already, please hit like and subscribe to this channel. Hit that bell notification so you won't miss any new content that's released. Now, before we get started, let's pray to the Lord. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you in Jesus' name for waking us up and allowing us to see another day that you alone have made. Father God, we acknowledge you for who you are today. And Lord, we praise you and worship you for who you are. Lord, we thank you in the name of Jesus, Lord, for bringing us here that we may fellowship and commune with you, Lord, and that we may spend time in your word to get to know you more and get to know who we are in you, Lord. Thank you for giving us our instructions on how to please you and how to live this life for your glory. And we ask in Jesus' name that your spirit, God, will lead and guide us this morning and all of your scripture. Please teach us and show us and help us, Lord, to comprehend all that you are saying in your word, that we may grow in the grace and knowledge of your son, Jesus Christ. And Lord, when you do these things, we will be mindful to give you praise, honor, and glory forever. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. So today's verse of the day is found in Matthew chapter 21, verse 9. Then the multitudes who went before and those who followed cried out, saying, "Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest." What a wonderful passage of scripture. In previous verses, Jesus was telling his disciples to go to an owner. Jesus was telling his disciples to go untie this young foal so he can ride on it. And even because Jesus is all-knowing, he knew the events that was going to unfold when it came to getting this young donkey. He predicted that the owner of that donkey would come out and say, "What do you need this for? What are you doing?" And Jesus told them exactly what to say, and that our Lord needs this. And the owner would let it go. And that's exactly what had happened in previous verses. So now that the disciples retrieved this donkey for the Lord, now we see Jesus Christ riding on the donkey of this donkey that's never been ridden before. One thing I love about Jesus is that he is so holy. He is just so wonderful that, you know, he gets the first. He gets the only. You know, even his tomb that was carved out was no one has ever laid in it before. No one has ever rode this donkey before, because remember, it's a young donkey. Probably before, never thought to be ridden, you know, until it became of age. But God saw this young donkey. And he rode on it. I think that's an amazing thing. Or you can say young colt. So anyway. So Jesus is riding on this colt. And people around him are laying branches before him as to signify his, in a sense, his sense of royalty, sense of who he is. So we see the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords riding on this colt, being treated as he is. But the people, strangely enough, are crying out something that they do not fully understand. And we're going to get into that today. They are crying out, the multitudes who went before him and those who are after him, they were crying out, "Hosanna to the Son of David." So they acknowledge Jesus to first and foremost be the Son of David. And that is one of the titles or names of Jesus. He is the Son of David, meaning that he has come from the line of kings, earthly speaking. He has come from a line of David, who was a king in Israel, and Solomon and so forth like that. So they acknowledge Jesus for being the Son of David, for being in that line of kings, and rightfully even having that position in earthly terms as king. But they cried out, "Hosanna to the son of David. We see this in, I believe it's Psalm chapter 118, verse 25, and where they cry out, please, Lord, please save us. Please, Lord, give us success. This is echoing the same thing, because Hosanna to the highest. Hosanna is a name for Jesus Christ. And a lot of times we say it during Easter time. Sometimes we just say it and don't really know why we're saying it, what's the meaning behind Hosanna. Hosanna means save, please. Different translations, in the original Greek, it was, I think it was Hosanna, and translated to Greek is Hosanna. Translated to English is, we say Hosanna, and this original intent in scripture is to mean save. So here we plug in that definition into what this multitude was crying out as Jesus was passing them by on the donkey with the branches laid underneath his feet. They're saying, save us, son of David. And most importantly, Hosanna has another meaning, and it means thank you, salvation, thank you. So the multitude did not quite and fully understand exactly what they were saying. They knew that they were crying out for Jesus Christ to save them. And they were crying out to Jesus Christ and saying, thank you for saving us, because they believed Jesus Christ to be the son of David in earthly terms, and that he was going to overthrow the Roman government, and that's going to be his kingdom. He's going to set up his earthly kingdom. But they had it right, but they got it wrong, because this same multitude that was crying out, Lord, please save us, or thank you for saving us, are the same people that cried out, in a very short while left, crucify him. Because they believed that Jesus came to save them from the earthly government and kingship of Rome. But Jesus Christ came from the lineage of David to save people from sin. That is our greatest foe. That is the worst enemy every human faces in this world. Jesus Christ came to save us from sin. And yes, they were right in crying out, Lord, please save us, or salvation, thank you, to the Son of David or to Jesus Christ. They were right in saying that, but they didn't see the whole picture. Even if Jesus Christ overthrew the Roman government while he was walking on this earth, they would still have a problem with sin. Jesus didn't deal with the symptom. He dealt with the cause of that those manifestations. He dealt with the problem that every human faces, and that's sin. And once we realize that we are sinners, we will realize that we need a savior. And when we realize that we need a savior, we will cry out like this multitude and say, Hosanna to the son of David. We will cry out, please, Lord, save us, save us. And one interesting thing about Psalm 118 is that the next verse in 26, we see a shift from crying out, Hosanna, please save us, to confidence in verse 26. And it says, blesses the one who comes in the name of the Lord. That is the same text that echoes in Matthew chapter 21, verse 9, in today's verse of the day. They had confidence that God, that Jesus Christ would be able to save them, but they did not understand that what he came to save is that which was lost. And that is people who realize that they need a savior because they are sinners. Brothers and sisters, let us not be confused why Jesus Christ exists, why he died on the cross, why he rose from the grave on the third day. Let us not be confused about who Jesus Christ is. He is God manifested in the flesh, who has come to die for the sins of the world and rose up on the third day with victory and power over death, hell, and the grave, that he may in turn give us life and life abundantly for those who believe on him. He didn't come to overthrow any type of earthly government while he walked on this earth. He came to overthrow sin once and for all by dying for us and rising again. Let us proclaim this truth. Let us celebrate the fact that Hosanna, the Son of David, has come. He has come to save us by the blood that he shed on Calvary. That is worthy of praise. That's worthy of worship. That is worthy of due respect. That is worthy of a Selah moment. Let us praise and worship the Lord for who he is. Comment below and share your thoughts on today's verse of the day. I'm very anxious to hear what you have to say. And as always, brothers and sisters, thank you so much for tuning in for another verse of the day. I hope and pray you come back tomorrow for more. And until then, may God bless you and have a beautiful and a wonderful day. Bye.